I have a video of Michael Irvin that we're...
Shit. Fuck. Damn. Oh.
That hurt.
Damn.
Fucking win. Ow.
Well, good morning, good people. Mark Holmes here. Of course, Joe Boo's holding down the fort at the Red Brick House. But we do have Joe Bear here. And as always, I want to say thank you all for watching, commenting, subscribing, and being part of the Joe Boo Sports Report. Without you guys, as well as you ladies, you know that this literally does not work. It is finally freaking Friday. The Cowboys have left Oxnard, and training camp is in the books. I can't believe that we have literally already gone through training camp. That time seemed to have gone through really, really quickly. Time flies when you're having fun, although I'm not sure how many Cowboy fans are really having fun right about now, because you look at the Dallas Cowboys and you say, you've done some great things. You've done things with smoke and mirrors. You have rebuilt this team since 2020 without doing any free agent signings. You've gone out, you find guys like Micah Parsons and Diggs. You find guys like Tyler Guyton and Cooper Beebe and, of course, Tyler Smith. You know, you plug the holes with guys like Terrence Steele, and you end up finding guys like, you know, that just left and right. You even have hits on UFL and USFL guys. You end up finding literally the kicker with the golden leg. And you look and say, my God, the Cowboys, they do so many great things. I mean, how the hell do we luck into Ceedee Lamb falling to us, or end up trading back and getting Micah Parsons and Goldston, or trading back and getting, you know, Tyler Guyton and Cooper Beebe, potentially two starting offensive linemen, one pick? You just say, that's some incredible shit. But yet, the Cowboys, which have had about as many wins in the regular season as anybody else that gets there close, but just seems to run out of steam by the time the playoffs get here, you could look and say, you could do the basic things, like get your player signed up early. You see, Ceedee Lamb has been here and been performing, has been getting better every year. Those guys that are doing the job seems to get treated the worst. The guys that are injured, that are okay, they get paid. And the Cowboys continue to cost themselves. You know, just think if the Cowboys had actually gotten Ceedee Lamb done last year, you know, got him in the books, and the year per average cost you, I don't know, $7 million less. And we're sitting here right now hampering our team because we don't have all the pieces there in training camp. In my mind, you need to get this thing done by Tuesday to get him in here for 2 weeks of practice before your first game. This is one person's perspective on how much it's going to be. We've heard that the offer, surprisingly, of under 33 million, which would make him the number two paid wide receiver, was rejected. And anybody surprised that the Cowboys' offer was rejected? It's always rejected. Stephen Jones is always lowballing people, but
I'm fascinated to see where the numbers would come in with Ceedee Lamb's contract, because the Justin Jefferson deal is there at 35 per year. The assumption is that it's going to be below that 35 a year. And that number, I think, is one we're all going to kind of keep our eye on. I mean, because Ceedee has played at a ridiculous level. This past year, he played at an unbelievable a level, and he was, like I mentioned, almost their entire passing offense. So his number is going to be a really, really interesting one. And the fact that he hasn't even been at camp is the one that makes it even more fascinating. He's staying in shape, to my understanding, obviously working out pretty well. But there's nothing like football shape. So he's got to get into camp, and that doesn't seem like it's really happening. Yeah, 33 for Lamb, like that's what a lot of people are kind of thinking, like that in kind of range right there. If you're looking at Ayuk's kind of in that 28, do you see Ceedee like in that 33? We'll see kind of, you know, what ends up happening.
There you have it. That's from, yeah. So the bigger question is this: why are the Cowboys still playing around with this thing? Why do they wait till the last minute to get things done? I wish I had the answer for that, but I just don't. It's maddening. It's not like there's all the receivers out there that are waiting to get paid and things. You've had constantly the numbers right there. It's just maddening to say, why are you continuing to do this to hurt your team? And people look at Dak Prescott, he sucks. You don't even have all those receivers in here. You don't even have all the parts. Well, Dak sucks. You don't even have, you know, your running game. You've got unexperienced guys and an old guy. Well, Dak sucks. And this is where it's maddening to me, where come the end of the season, it's going to be already, well, it's Dak's fault. It's Dak's fault. You're going to forget about the holdout of Ceedee Lamb and literally pissing your players off. I'm just wondering, if you get treated like this is your job, do you go out there and say, I'm happy about being here and this, that, and the other, and you really want to go out and perform? Or do you kind of say, F the man? I kind of feel it. You say, F the man. But it is what it is. Tomorrow night, we have our final preseason game against the Chargers. And this, of course, will be the Consolation Bowl. This will be the last opportunity to impress the coaches if you're on the bubble, or to impress other teams. And this, again, is still very, very consequential for the Cowboys, because this is the time where you look and you say, we can make some moves and bring in some people that might be able to make a difference on this squad. After you've gone through training camp and you evaluated each of the positions and you say, here's where we need more depth, or here's where we need another starter, here's where we need another player. The Cowboys, if Tyler Guyton and Cooper Beebe work out as starters, the Cowboys could potentially have a very good offensive line. But that's not the problem. The problem is the backups. Where are we with backups on the offensive line? Where are we with backups on the defensive line? And so on. And this is where are we with running back? And this is where you look at it and say, the Cowboys, contrary to what you believe or hear from the talking heads and stuff, are a team that I believe is closer to being able to be really, really good. But they need to top it off. You know, that's been the problem. Top it off to anticipate losing people or players wearing down. So let's see. This is an interesting topic. Are the Cowboys closer to the Super Bowl or missing the playoffs?
But this is a damn good question. This is a perfect question, because the honest answer is, everybody is closer to missing the playoffs than the Super Bowl. Like, it's just much easier for an injury or a fluke to happen. You fall out of playoffs, then you just randomly find yourself at the Super Bowl. But I'm going to say they're probably closer to the Super Bowl, because they do have a top-of-the-league quarterback. They have a few all-pros on defense. They do have some issues, but every team has problems. So I know their postseason woes are something that's going to be hard for a lot of people to forget, but this team missing the playoffs seems a lot more unlikely to me, considering that they've been 12-win team for the past 3 years. That seems more unlikely to me than them winning the Super Bowl.
Yeah, despite sort of this circus that's going around with Jerry Jones and the Dallas Cowboys, he said yesterday that he's not really tripping on the way things are with Ceedee Lamb right now, and he explained why.
I don't mean that to be insensitive to our fans or to Ceedee, but we're in good shape there, and we are having promising talks. Say, well, why do you keep talking? Won't you do something? Again, as in anything, it takes both of you there at the same time. But none of us, player or teams, want it to hurt the preparation or the likelihood of playing at your best opening day.
Okay. Jerry Jones Sound like the dude at the dance that the girl keeps
trap so
at.
Tight.
She's like, why you keep talking? Do something. Let's get right. Mike T, what level of concern do you have with Jerry Jones and the way that he's been dealing with the Ceedee Lamb situation?
Yeah, he hasn't done much right with that at all. Like, if we went back to the start of the offseason back in March and looking at Davante Adams at roughly $28 million a year, guys, nothing in the receiver market has been a surprise from Jalen Waddle, Amara St. Brown, all the way up to Justin Jefferson now at $35 million plus a year. The Dallas Cowboys, guys, to be clear, have cost themselves a minimum of $7 million a year per year. And on a five-year deal, that's at least $35 million that they could be investing in Dak Prescott, Micah Parsons, amongst others. I don't know what
the benefit
was. How
about the $50 million that you did with Michael?
You think people in the Dallas office are dapping each other off every time Jerry Jones talks about these things? Like, yep, that's exactly how we planned it.
Yeah, because no one in that building can say, oh, you know what our ultimate plan was? That on August 20th or August 21st, we'd be 18 days away from having to see Myles Garrett and that Browns defense in week one, and Ceedee Lamb is still MIA. No one can tell us that that was the master plan. You know why? Because that master plan makes no sense. So I understand we all assume this is going to get done because they've been talking all camp. So at some point, you assume it's going to get done. But we're 2 weeks away, guys. It's not just him getting a contract signed. It's him getting on the field and practicing in order to be ready for week one.
You know, Kmart, something you love to remind me of is, you know, you talked about getting ready for Cleveland. I was part of a big holdout with Darrelle Revis, and I felt like I was laying the team down, the organization down, RC, because we had a great team. Mm-hmm. You come back off of injury, and all of a sudden, you know, the risk of injury because of a holdout is really high. And Darrelle Revis got hurt against the Patriots trying to cover Randy Moss. You got video of it right here, and you can see Darrelle pull up here. That really hurt us that season. So, look, you hope Ceedee comes in. He's in great shape. But injuries after holdouts happen frequently.
Mike T, I don't know if you was ever chasing a dude that ran 4-2, but your hamstring is going to get pulled whether you've been in camp or not.
Oh, I feel better.
That had nothing to do with camp. That had to do with Randy Moss.
You're finally off the
hook. Yeah, that had to do
after
with
14 years, I feel better.
Neek, when you look at this situation, though, how vital is it for Jerry Jones to make something happen to get Ceedee Lamb in camp?
I ain't appreciate the judgment in Mike's voice. Like, that's random. Like, let's be clear. But I'll say, like, being a general manager or running a team is incredibly difficult. But there are some things that are really easy. You draft a good player, the sooner you pay him, the better off you will be. There is no benefit for them to continue to wait. And I'm someone who believes a great player who's a veteran doesn't need a whole lot of practice. And RC and I were part of eliminating two-a-days back in old school CBA negotiations. But I ain't with none of days. You can't
leave. Yeah, there you go.
So while the hamstring may not be torn because you missed a practice here or there, you're certainly not going to be completely ready if you're not doing nothing. You ain't caught one ball from Dak Prescott or run one route out there in Oxnard. That's a problem. And again, to Mike T's first point, to what benefit? How's this helping you? He's not getting cheaper. You're not getting better. You're not making him fall more in love with your organization. Like, there is no benefit of this other than giving us something to talk about. So I guess we should be grateful.
Mm-hmm. Mike T, how quickly does this need to be done?
Right away, because to Neek's point, he needs some reps with Dak Prescott despite them being together. And Cleveland has a great defense on opening day. So to me, there is a sense of urgency. We all expect to get done, but RC, every day that it doesn't, it diminishes their chances of winning on opening day.
Kimberly, if not now, then when?
You asking me? I don't know. Ask Jerry. Jerry's talking about, I don't feel it. I'm not stressed. I'm not tense. I'm not worried. Okay. I won't be worried either. I'll be there week one. Tom Brady and I will be there. So will Jerry. We'll see if CD is there.
Well, the thing about week one is who going to be dressed the best, Kimberly or Tom Brady? Because we know Tom is coming in.
All right. We're falling off the cliff here. We're talking about who's going to be best dressed. We'll see what the day holds with the Dallas Cowboys. I'm up here early. I've got to take care of some business and things. And maybe today will be a better day for the Cowboys as they get ready for their final preseason game. As always, I appreciate you guys. Peace out.
Mark Holmes here, and as always, I want to thank you all for watching, commenting, subscribing, and being part of the Joe Boo Sports Report.